Assalamu alaikum and welcome back again. I'm trying to choose different words, right? Because my granddaughter is making fun of me. Okay. When you have little children, they know how to make fun of you. Wait till it's your turn. I'll make fun of you. You can't win. I have viewers making fun and then I have got my granddaughter making fun of me. That's not very nice, is it? Okay. Well, okay. Now then, this suit is initially was meant to be a three-piece suit. We've sort of put more spices into it because we went a little bit extravagant, and with all the leftover fabric we managed to achieve so much. So what did we manage to do? Well, the leftover pieces from that fabric we made a salwar, because the customers wanted something different from a trouser. So we went for a traditional salwar, and we went for, this is meant to be a lining, but it's good enough to wear as a dress. And it's a straightforward dress that is going to be worn underneath a jacket. Now, with this jacket, what we've done is made trousers. And this was the embroidery that had come off the front of the jacket. And I've used it to do the ponchas. So beautiful it has come out. This is the latest fashion has been, you may have seen quite a lot of the trousers with buttons and also embroidered pieces. So whether you're wearing a trouser, these kind of fashions do tend to go in and out. So with the salwar, traditional salwar, that never goes out. Okay, so what did we do with the jacket? This is, I suppose, this is the, what's it called? The icing on the cake. Okay, and I'm going to show you. It really needs to be worn to be appreciated. What I'm going to do is I'm going to try and align the dress and then explain what it is. Oh, Inaya, stop it, please. We're going to try and line the jacket first, because you can't really tell what we've managed to achieve without fully being displayed. Okay, it's a straight jacket. Not a straight jacket. It's a slightly trail jacket, but without the cutting and the pieces. And I tell you, this is just gorgeous. I absolutely, absolutely love this. And that's basically what it looks like. Now, if you watch the early video, I was saying I was going to play about with this because I hadn't decided what I was going to do. It is slightly trailed, and what I opted to do was I found this beautiful green lace that went with perfectly with the color of the embroidery in the dress. So I went along with that, and I used the lace at the hemline. Now, initially, what I was saying was I was going to use the pearls at the bottom. So I decided to use the pearls on the edging side. And now, if you look at the trouser that goes with... Okay. Oh. We need to spread all this out so you can see the whole of... Now, the green lace, I've edged the bottom of the dress, the chemise as well, so that it gives like the look. And then the trouser, obviously, with the embroidery, goes with the jacket. So this is like such a delicate and beautiful suit. You know, beautifully combined, and the result is just amazing, especially when you then look at the dupatta as well. I did pull the white beading off, white edging off, and then I applied pearls and the pink lace. So the whole combination of this suit is just amazingly pretty. I absolutely adore it. I'm well proud of the result on this, and Alhamdulillah, you know what, a real worthwhile investment if you're willing to put the effort into making something like this. Now, the suit itself is £28, but when you go on to stitch this and when you add all the extras like the laces and the pearls and You know, it is gonna, the price is gonna go up quite a bit, and then especially if you're gonna get it tailored like this, someone stitching something like this, if I'm stitching something like this for someone, I'll tell you, I would be charging £35-40 easily for it, because there is a lot of time and effort that's gone into this. Obviously everything, if somebody's putting the extra effort in, like applying all the laces, again, it's not just applying all the laces and so on. With these suits, you do have to unpick, but then you do get a fabulous result. Now, I suppose if you're having stuff done in India, Pakistan, then you could be paying a lot less price. But sadly, when you're trying to explain to someone that I want it doing like this and like this, you know what, nobody is going to understand what you're on about, unless you're willing to really put the time and effort in yourself to stitch something like this. Now I'm going to put it on a mannequin and I'm going to take a few shots and see if I can give you a better view of it on a mannequin. So I think it's only then that you fully appreciate, or maybe perhaps somebody wearing it. Now I have got a friend who's agreed to model these for me. It depends on when I can get a hold of her, but if she will, she's about this size, so, and she's a very, very pretty girl, and I think she's going to do justice to wearing this and showing this off for me if I can twist her arm to come and do it for me. So there's only just one final touch that I'm going to add, and that's just perhaps just a hook at the top, just to you know, finish it off. But apart from that, it's all done, and well pleased with the result.
I got this.